What's up guys, Gagan here, back again with another video. Today in this video I'm going to show you how can you install an FTP server on your local machine. So for this, press Windows plus R key and right control. It will take you to control panel. In control panel, search for programs and features. Click on programs and features, and in next page click on turn Windows features on or off. Now see Internet Information Services, expand that and check FTP server, web management tools and World Wide Web services. Check all these three and click on OK. It will install an FTP feature on your Windows. So go back to search for this FTP server and click on Administrative Tools. In administrative tools, search for Internet Information Services. It's showing here because I already have installed this services on my local machine. So click on this. It will take you to the FTP feature of this window. So here you can see that it's showing my local machine name. So for hosting any website on your FTP server, click on your local machine name and right click on that and click on add FTP site. Now you have to give a name to your FTP site. So I'm writing here, for example, FTP site. Okay. So on FTP site, what do you want to share to your users? So you have to give the physical path to that file. So for giving physical path to that file, I am selecting local disk D. I have created a test file, so I am giving path for this file so that my users will be able to access this test file. Okay, so click next, and here you have to give an IP address so that your users will be able to search for your FTP server and the website you have hosted on your FTP server. So here I am giving this an IP address of my local machine. So for verifying this IP address, you can use Windows plus R key and type cmd, and in cmd you have to write ip config to verify your IP address. So here you can see that in IP version 4 address, this is my IP address of local machine, 192.168.43.87. so the same IP address I have selected here. So in next, port number, you have to give the port number. So FTP server automatically runs on 20 and 21 port number. So by default it selected the port number 21. So in next, it's asking for do you want to enable virtual host names. So as of now I'm not going to enable this feature. So in next, for starting the FTP site automatically, click on start FTP site automatically. And in next, it's asking for SSL certificate. If you have an SSL certificate for securing your website, so click on allow SSL and give the SSL certificate. So as of now I don't have any SSL certificate, so I'm clicking on no SSL and click on next. In authentication, it's asking for anonymous or basic, so I'm clicking on both. So in authorization, it's asking for to whom you want to give authorization. So I'm giving authorization for all my users. And in permission, it's asking for whether you want to give read permission or write permission to your users. So I am giving the permission of read only. So click on finish. So here the FTP site has been added to this server. So so for verifying this FTP site, you can see your website from your browser. And so for this, I am going to browse this site in Firefox web browser. So here in search box you have to write the same IP address of your local machine. So for accessing the FTP site, you have to write here FTP:// and IP address of your local machine. So the IP address of my local machine was 192.168.43.87. So now you can see that I'm able to access my FTP server. So I'm able to access that file. I have given the path from my local machine. So that's how an FTP server is installed. So thanks for watching this video, and please consider to like and subscribe my channel for future updates. Keep watching.